Hi, it's Anya from Anya Photo and Digital Painterly. Today I'm going to show you a very quick tutorial how you can transform picture of your pets into the royal or old master's painting using my templates. I'm going to leave the link below in description where you can find them. And just to let you know, the Gimp software is free. It is not as advanced as Photoshop. It hasn't got the same possibilities, abilities, but it is good if you don't want to really invest in software. You just want a one-off picture or from time to time make a pet portrait and that's it. So this might be for you, and let me show you. So once you install the software on your computer, you will see this. It's like a default. I haven't changed any settings. This is what I downloaded this morning, and this is what I have. So, file, open, and we're going to choose our template first of all, the image of template. So, if I'm using the space bar on my keyboard, the long button, and I'm just moving with my mouse without clicking, I can move my image around. I'm letting go of the space bar and it stays here. If you want to see the image a little bit bigger, you just go here and choose different percentage. So this is fitting the whole screen. Next thing, we need to import our image. So we go File, Open as Layers. That's important bit. And we choosing our pet picture. It's really good to have the same facing image. Oh, and sometimes you might get a message like this. And I'm happy with everything, so just keep. So this is the image of my, not my cat, the cat I'm going to use the image of. And you can see on the right here, you have those two layers. So the cat layer and the template layer. So now, just so it's easier for me to adjust it, and you have to be the judge of it, how big the head of your pet needs to be to work together. So I'm going to change the opacity here, just so it's much easier to select the right size. So we ideally would like this cat to face the other way. So here under your tools, you can see different tools for rotation, for transformation, and we're going to use the flip tool. So if you press Shift and F together on your keyboard, it might be different for Mac. And then I'm pressing on that image with a mouse, then my cat is looking different way, and that's what we want. This time we're going to, oh, I keep pressing that. We need to select a different tool from our transform family, which is going to be scale. So we are changing the size of this little guy or girl. Now I'm just guessing now. So I changed that tool here, pressed on the right mouse click, scale. And then with my mouse, without touching anything on the keyboard, I'm just sliding it into the center. So that's my cat size. And I'm just guessing roughly that's going to be the right size. And now move tool. It applied that change. Maybe, is that going to work? Maybe a little bit smaller. So again, right click scale. They have some keyboard shortcuts as well if you want to use that, but this is the I'm trying to do it as simple as possible so you don't have to do the whole lessons on GIMP. Great, we have scale, and I think he needs to be slightly rotated. So from the same family of tools, rotate, and we're going to gently adjust that. So that's why I changed the opacity, so I can see what's happening underneath. So now we have roughly our cat in place. You can always kind of adjust it slightly. I'm going to make it slightly bigger so I can see what's happening. Oh, that is very big, might be too much. Apologies for this loud keyboard sounds. Maybe 50%, oh, that's better. And I still have that move tool. So you see the cat's head is much bigger, but don't worry too much because all we need is kind of his head. We're not going to include that neck. So the best way to, I'm just going to increase opacity a tiny bit more. The best way to kind of select just his head here is to do layer mask. So I'm right clicking and add layer mask. And a white for opacity is the one we want. Add. So what happened now, you can see like a second window here and new layers. This is just your image. This is layer mask. And if you haven't worked with your masks before, don't worry. It's a really simple concept. And so we need to use the brush, just normal soft brush here. And what we're going to do, we're going to use the black of the brush. Let's bring the opacity all the way down so you can see exactly what's happening. Okay, start just here. So I'm erasing with my black brush things I don't need. Make sure the force is 100 here because we're just going, try not to go too close to edge of your subject, just getting rid of this background. So you can even increase the size a little bit to do it quickly and efficiently. So you don't spend all day doing that and just keep brushing that away. So what happens if you accidentally go over? You just go here and you do white brush and you bring it back. That's why it's so much better than eraser, because you can always come back, and then we're going to do further editing of the fur, so you can see how we can do it so it's more believable. In Photoshop you have the special artificial intelligence helping so much with defining the fur, how to make it more realistically looking. Button here, you have to be a bit more creative. So I'm using my, making it smaller here, a little smaller, a little closer. You can go even closer with your view if you want to have a closer look. I'm going to go even closer with my brush, just a bit more, and really close to this cat's there, so nothing is showing. Obviously it really helps if you have your picture, for example, in light background, and your template is also in light, so that's fantastic, but it's not always possible, and you can still make it work. So now what we're going to do, we're going to just delete that a little bit more. That's too strong. False. I'm taking down to, let's say, 23, and just very, very gently brushing off because I don't want it to be too vivid on the edges. And now to make it, you have different creatures, different lovely animals, different fur, different hair. So what we're going to do, we're going to create tiny, tiny brush, literally 1.1. size of a one. I'm going to make it very close, pressing my space bar, and now we're going to use different brush. From your selection here, I'm going to choose a grass. I know it's not very obvious choice, but it has a nice texture and it's not so obvious actually. And what I'm doing with my black brush, I'm just adding on here and there, brushing that fur so it looks like it's a fur. And just to add on, guys, here on your layers, sometimes if you accidentally switch on your layer, you might see that. You want to make sure you're on a mask, okay? So that's how it works. Black hides and white shows. And I just keep going, you can go teeny bit bigger and just making those in. And this is, it really is up to you how much time you want to spend here. And sometimes it's, you have to stop yourself somewhere. Okay, so maybe just, you don't want to make it too neat, so it doesn't look like a sunflower. And now I'm going to swap to white. So I'm going to restore some of it again. And it's basically the dance between black and white here, and just taking away, bring it in. And if you spend some time on it, it really will pay off. And just watch the way, direction that your animal's hair, fur is growing. It's not going to be always the same straight way. Like you can see, there's different direction on here. Sometimes not very visible. I'm going like that, and I'm changing to white and bringing it back, especially kind of closer to middle of the hair here, bringing it back. That's more like it. Should have chosen the black one. And how's that looking? That's much better. That's it. Let's take a look and a distance. That's really nice. He can just adjust his, oh, I have moved the mask instead, so make sure you select that image rather than mask and just place it right there. So what we want to do now, because as you can see, the painting is a little bit more muted, the colors, it will be always more muted than the photograph, so we want that to change. Okay, so you select that layer, make sure it's not a mask, it's the layer, and now go to colors and hue saturation, and we're going to drop saturation just a touch here, so you can see the difference how far that goes. And you have to go by eye, you have to think what suits that painting. And okay, and that's lovely. Just going to adjust a little bit here. I'm selecting now my layer, my painting. This works quite nicely here, but in case you have slightly different image, I wanted to show you what you can do to add shadows here and there. And be careful when you add them, because the shadows are the ones that create the believable effect. So the more real shadows are, the more realistic the painting is going to look. So I'm going to just add the empty layer here, add, okay, and I'm going to change opacity is 100% for now. Mode, here you have press mode and choose multiply, just here, multiply. And you can use the same brush, or you can use maybe the soft brush, that would be probably better, one of these. For hardness, 0, force some of it, and now we want to choose, if we for example want this coat to be a little bit in the shadow, just under his head, so pick the color. And now you can see here, you can color pick from your image. So I'm just choosing that. Okay. So that's going to give me very nice shadow. So I'm going to make it slightly bigger, force lower, and very, very, very gently just touching. Photoshop has many more options, I have to admit. And this is an eraser, so if you've gone over, and remember this is your empty layer, so you're not affecting the cat, you're just affecting what you painted, that shadow. So that works nicely. Okay, so our picture is looking pretty good so far. We have one more job to do. So what we're going to do, we're going to add the texture. I'm going to make it smaller, so is there any chance to make it smaller? There we go. Okay, great. So File, Open as Layer, and I'm choosing my texture. Open. You can make texture out of anything, really, guys. You can take a picture of the wall or something that has a scratchiness. You can experiment. That's so much fun as well. So keep again. And you see the cat is on top only because this is texture needs to be on top of everything. Little arrows here, just going to bring it up and that goes on top. Now I have to rotate this guy. So I'm pressing my, I already have a rotate here, which is Shift R if you want to use the shortcuts on your keyboard. And that's brilliant. Enter. And it's rotating my texture. Lovely. At the moment we can't see anything. We need to change our mode here on top. Soft light. So that gives us a very, very gentle, subtle change. I don't know if you can even see that. So this is my cat here sitting nicely. Let's just take a closer look. 50%. I'm pretty happy with that. What you can do, you can repeat that procedure again with the texture. You can try and maybe have a little go with different type of modes here. Hard light, give you a little bit more texture bits. We can do multiply very dark, so you might need to change the opacity, but it just makes it a bit duller. What I like is really the soft light. And that looks pretty good. So the last thing we need to do is go into this panel of layers, right click and press flatten image. And that basically brings all your layers together into one image. And this is done. And when you're finished with your image, you go to File and Export As. And as a default, it's going to save as a JPEG. So just export. And this already exists. Cancel, because I'm going to write over my template. So I'm going to put some extra sign in there, whatever that you want. Export. And export. And that is now created, the image. So I hope that was easy and understandable. Apologies if I was waffling a little bit. I did literally learn this software today, this morning, and wanted to make sure that just essentials are included. If you want to do more elaborate, more sophisticated changes, I definitely recommend Photoshop, but I understand that Photoshop costs money, and if you want to just one-off image, this is definitely enough. Till next time, thank you so much. Bye.